Can't you see that you're lost without me? I can feel the thunder that's breaking in your heart. I can see through the stars inside you. Hi, Baldy Jack here, and today's video is on the McFarlane Toys Movie Maniacs, Jason Voorhees figure? Jason goes to hell, maybe? I don't know, let's take a look at it.
They say evil wears many different masks, but pure evil wears only one. Today we're taking a look at McFarlane Toys' 1998 release of the Jason Voorhees Jason Goes to Hell figure. And yeah, that's correct, 1998 was when this figure was released. It's 20 years old as of now, pushing 21 later this fall. So first off, you know, as usual, we'll take a look at his accessories, that being, you know, his arsenal. So what we have here is a machete. This, usually with these releases, the machete usually is like a metallic silver, but for some reason mine has like this matte black with a tad bit of blood splatter. You can kind of slightly see the metallic right there. And then we have, I believe this is a spear. Has a tad bit of blood on the edge here, but just a little bit of sprinkles. And then lastly, we have a one-sided axe. Definitely has a tad bit of blood. Looks like he, you know, smacked someone in the forehead with this thing. So, you know, that really breaks down to the idea that what Jason is this? So we can take a look at this massive piece that a lot of these movie Maniac figures came with, but then later on throughout the series, this whole display base with the poster would downscale in size as the series moved on. But yeah, this thing is, you know, quite massive. You have just a bunch of different skulls here and there. You have some spinal work. I think this is a pretty badass looking piece. It's kind of a shame that as they further went down this line, you know, as I said, the base got smaller and it was like practically just an insert card that held the poster. Taking a look at the figure himself, here you have Jason, which it ain't one of the best figures. It is by far a very dated figure, as you can kind of tell, articulation wise, a tad bit sculpt wise, especially that mask. Taking a look at the figure, the proper rundown here, you can tell that this doesn't really quite look like Jason Goes to Hell. Hell, no pun intended, but, you know, this is more proper, you know, accurate to how he looked in this film. Here up in the arms, we have where the shirt is torn away kind of near the forearm. He has black gloves, and it's like, what Jason film does that remind you of? And you're like, oh, wait, Friday the 13th Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. So this figure right here is pretty much kind of like a hybrid of Friday the 13th Part 8 and Jason Goes to Hell, which is kind of weird. Not gonna lie, it looks kind of odd. I still think the sculpt kind of does hold up. It's pretty detailed. His skin here looks like, looks very bubbly. Very reminiscent of, like I said, Part 8. And, you know, a tad bit of 9. They kind of had similar skin texture, but it was kind of similar in a way, not color. Definitely have quite a bit of rips and tears in the pants. He has some blood on his crotch. I don't think Jason is female here, you know. It's kind of a weird spot, but okay. You have his back here with some more exposed flesh. Man, his flesh just looks, ugh, just looks kind of melted. Kind of distorted in a way. As far as the mask goes, yeah, this ain't the best thing in the world. It's, like I said, very dated. And a matter of fact, you can remove the mask, but, you know, most people had to pry it off. Mine came off pretty easily, so that is his face. Yes, yeah, definitely this is kind of reminiscent of, you know, Jason Goes to Hell, even though never saw his face in the movie. You know, as we know, we barely saw him in the movie. But, yeah, his face was kind of like that. It was kind of bony, you know, missing his right eye. His nose, yeah, that's, you know, gone too. Yeah, like, his face was, you know, practically just skull. With, you know, flesh growing around it, and he had a little bit of blood here and there. Just sticking that back on there, I actually have some tape holding it together. You know, articulation-wise, everything he has on him is basically swivel joints. You know, you have it in the legs, you have it in the elbow, kind of in the bicep a little bit up here. You kind of swivel at the waist. It's very, very limited. For a 21-year-old figure, it looks pretty good, not gonna lie. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that this is the very first Jason action figure that we ever got. Beforehand, most of the stuff was statues and whatnot, like Kit Bash type stuff. That, you know, you buy the statue, you gotta paint it yourself and whatnot. Nowadays, really easy to get. You can get it for like 20, 30 bucks. It's pretty cheap. You can find it easily, whether it's new, you know, out of package. Pretty easy to get a hold of. So in conclusion, it's a nice figure. Yes, it's not specific to the film that McFarlane's trying to say he's from. More or less, it's like a combination of two different Jasons into one. And if you wanted to, you could theoretically repaint this figure with a gray, black, and then put an overall clear coat over the figure with some glossy paint. And you'd pretty much almost be good to go to make this a Jason Takes Manhattan figure, as we don't have one officially. Hopefully NECA can do one, you know, later down the road. But yeah, pretty much you could easily do that and then find like a mask, customize it to your liking. Easily have yourself a Jason Takes Manhattan figure. So, with that, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. And until then, enjoy this photo gallery. And see you all next time.